सुप्रभातम मित्रों एंड वेलकम बैक इन संस्कृत सुभाषित वैभव चैप्टर नंबर 5 द ग्लोरी ऑफ गुड सेइंग। इन श्लोक नंबर 1 वी हैव सीन द गुड क्वालिटीज ऑफ अ रीडर। तो क्वेश्चन मे बी आस्क्ड इन टू द संस्कृत और मे बी इन द इंग्लिश, पाठकानां कति गुणा संति, कति मीन्स हाउ मैनी क्वालिटी डज अ रीडर हैव। तो वी कैन से इन संस्कृत पाठकानां षड गुणा संति, पाठकानां षड मीन्स षट गुणा संति। Whether we want to give the answer into English, so we can say there, a good reader should have 6 qualities. Similarly, in slok number 2, with the question it is asked in a Sanskrit, chala chale sansare kim jivati, so we can answer that, चला चले संसारे, संसार मीन्स जगतम विश्व, चला चले संसारे कीर्ति ही जीवती, और जीव इंस्टेड ऑफ जीवती वी कैन ऑल्सो से निश्चलम। इट इज आस्क्ड इन द क्वेश्चन व्हाट डज लीव इन द वर्ल्ड, तो वी कैन से दैट ओनली फेम, फेम मीन्स रेपुटेशन lives in this mortal world, we can say that. Similarly, Subhasita number 3, Maksikaha Vranam Ichchanti. In Sanskrit, we can ask for a question. For example, Ke Vranam Ichchanti? Ke Vranam इच्छन्ति, तो इन प्लेस ऑफ के वी आर गिविंग द आंसर मत्सिकाः व्रणम इच्छन्ति। द संधि इज देयर इन दिस लाइन व्रणम प्लस इच्छन्ति। सिमिलरली क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, के धनम इच्छन्ति, तो आंसरिंग इन प्लेस ऑफ के वी आर यूजिंग द आंसर पार्थिवः, वी कैन ऑल्सो से नूपाः, वी कैन ऑल्सो से भूपाः, धनम इच्छन्ति, संधि इज देयर धनम प्लस इच्छन्ति। सिमिलरली लाइन नंबर 2, के कलहम कलहम इच्छन्ति, आंसर इज नीचाः कलहम इच्छन्ति। क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, के शांति इच्छन्ति, आंसर इज इन प्लेस ऑफ के साधवः शांति इच्छन्ति। नाउ श्लोक नंबर 4, गावो गंधेन पच्यन्ति वेदैः पच्यन्ति ब्राह्मणाः, चारैः पश्यन्ति राजन चक्षु अभ्युमितरे जनाः। हियर द पोएट सेड गावो मीन्स काउज एंड पश्यन्ति, पश्य मीन्स टू सी, काउज सी गंधेन बाय स्मेल, the cow, the smelling power of a cow, it is very powerful. Just like a dog, the dog smelling power, it is also very very effective, and because of the smelling power even the police department have also the dogs, and using the dogs they can find out the criminals or they do the investigation in crime. Similarly, the elephant, the trunk sound of the elephant, it also smell from the very distance. In which direction there is a water, the elephant can easily judge it through the smelling power. So here, the cow has a smelling power, and because of that power, strength, the cow can see. So we can say that cows see by smell. Similarly, Brahmanah Vedaihi Pashyanti Brahmanah. In the olden days, the society is divided into four parts: Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. And it is the responsibility of Brahman to learn the Ved, Puran and the other religious books, and whatever knowledge it is given in those books, they give it to the others. And whenever Brahman used to talk with others, so they can understand that the person with whom they were talking were knowledgeable or not. They had the knowledge of Vedas, Puran and Shastras, because they were very powerful in Vedas. And definitely, whenever we talk with others, so we can also easily understand whether the person with whom we are talking is knowledgeable or not, whether he having the knowledge of Ved, Puran and any other holy books. It is easily understood by us. So here, Brahman sees by Vedas. Next one, it is said that Rajan Charahi Pashyanti. Rajan means kings, Raja, kings. Pashyanti, see. Charahi, spy we call it. Here plural is that, spies. Or we call it secret agents. So kings see through their spies. Spy means jasus, S-P-Y. Here plural, S-P-I-E-S. Kings see through their spies. And last one, it is said that Chakshuhu Abhyarth Anya Janaha Abhitarehe Rajan Chakshubhyam Itare Janaha. Itare means common people. Pashyanti, see. Chakshuhu, eyes we call it. The common people see with their eyes. Common people means we people. Generally we do not use the mind and the another smelling power. Simply we see using our eyes. So here the translation, it is cow sees by smell, Brahman sees by Vedas, king sees through their spies, and common people see with their eyes. Now one word, Chakshu, is there, and this word Chakshu is having some synonyms. For example, Lochanam. Another one, Nayanam. And last one, Netram. I again repeat it. Chakshuhu, Lochanam, Nayanam, Netram. These are the synonyms of the word Chakshu. Let me proceed. on Subhashit number 5. This Subhashit, it is given to by heart. You have to learn it like Subhashit number 2. So here it is said that दरिद्राय धनं देयं ज्ञानं देयं जडाय च पिपासिताय पानीयं क्षुधिचाय च भोजनम्. I repeat again. दरिद्राय धनं देयं ज्ञानं देयं जडाय च पिपासिताय पानीयं क्षुधिताय च भोजनम्. Here poet said that दरिद्र means the poor. Deyam, deya, to give. What? Dhanam. We call it money or wealth. In sloka number 2, we have already learned the synonyms of the word dhanam. Dhanam means vittam. We call also said dravyam, artham, and here dhanam. Dhanam, vittam, dravyam. The words dhanam. So the poor should be given money. We should give the particular thing according to the desire of the person. So this is the moral of this Subhashit. कि जिसको जिसकी जरूरत है वही चीज देनी चाहिए. सपोज भैंस है, भैंस बफेलो, उसको आप गीता का ज्ञान दोगे तो क्या उसके लिए ये उचित है? बिल्कुल नहीं. उसको तो खाना चाहिए, अब खाना देगो तो गीता का ज्ञान उसके लिए बिल्कुल जरूर नहीं है. जिसको जिस चीज़ की ज़रूरत है वही चीज़ दीजिए. यू शुड हैव द नॉलेज ऑफ दैट थिंग कि वॉट आई शुड गिव टू द अदर पर्सन according to the requirement of that person. Otherwise, whatever it is given by you, it is useless. For example, जब भगवान राम जी ने लंका पर विजय प्राप्त करके जब अयोध्या में वापस आए तो हनुमान का इसमें बहुत बड़ा contribution था रावण को मारने में. तो अयोध्या में आने के बाद सीता जी हनुमान जी पर बहुत प्रसन्न हुए और उन्होंने भगवान हनुमान को मोती की माला दी. तो हनुमान जी ने जैसे ही मोती की माला ली तो वो एक एक मणका उसका तोड़कर जमीन पर फेंकने लगे. एंड दैट वन वॉज बींग ऑब्जर्व बाय मदर सीता. सो ही आस्क द क्वेश्चन टू हनुमान कि व्हाट आर यू डूइंग? You do not know the importance of this garland of pearl. And at that time Hanuman ji said that कि मोती की माला में जिस वस्तु के अंदर मेरे भगवान राम नहीं है उस वस्तु का मेरे जीवन में कोई मूल्य नहीं है, चाहे वह वस्तु कितनी भी मूल्यवान है. तो यहाँ हमें इस बात का ध्यान रखना है देते समय कि उस व्यक्ति को क्या जरूरत है. तो हियर द पुअर शुड बी गिवन मनी. गरीब है उसको धन की जरूरत है. नेक्स्ट वन इट इज सेड दैट ज्ञानम देयम जड़ाय च. जड़ इग्नोरेंट, हु हैविंग नॉट द नॉलेज वी कॉल इट इग्नोरेंट, अज्ञानी. ज्ञानम देयम शुड बी गिवन नॉलेज. द इग्नोरेंट शुड बी गिवन नॉलेज. अब जो अज्ञानी है उसको आप धन देंगे तो उसको ये पता नहीं चला. ही शुड ही द इग्नोरेंट पीपल शुड नॉट हैविंग द नॉलेज हाउ टू यूज द मनी. तो फर्स्ट बिफोर गिविंग द मनी we should give the proper knowledge how to spend or how to utilize the money. Otherwise, the money Instead, without the knowledge we call it, it is useless to the ignorant people. So the line number first is, the poor should be given money, the ignorant should be given knowledge. In line number two, pipasitaya paniyam, pipasitaya, thirsty, जिसको पानी की ज़रूरत है, वी कॉल इट थर्स्टी. इन चैप्टर नंबर टू वी लर्न दैट वन. द यंग वन ऑफ चाता बीइंग थर्स्टी, ही गोज टू हिज मदर एंड सेज, हम जलम पातुम इच्छामि. तो हियर वाटर शुड बी पानीयम, वाटर जलम, नीरम तोयम, पयः पानीयम पिपासिताय, वाटर शुड बी गिवन टू द थर्स्टी. एंड लास्ट वन इट इज सेड देन, शुद्धिताय च भोजनम. शुद्धिताय मीन्स हंग्री, द पर्सन हु इज वेरी हंग्री. एंड वी नोट दैट द हंग्री पर्सन नीड्स भोजनम, फूड वी कॉल इट. सो द लास्ट लाइन्स ट्रांसलेशन इज, द फूड शुड बी गिवन टू द हंग्री. The food should be given to the hungry. So the complete translation it is, the poor should be given money, the ignorant should be given knowledge, water should be given to the thirsty, and food should be given to the hungry. Hello guys, again I would like to focus on line number one, the poor should be given money. This line, it is used in a passive voice, should, and whenever there is a should, we use be before main verb, past participle, given, be given. So this line can be said like this one, money should be given to the poor. I repeat again, the poor should be given money, or money should be given to the poor. We have to use to before the noun the poor. For example, father gives me money, to object there, me and money. So we can say that money is given to me by father. Or we can also say that I am given money, I am given money by father. Let me proceed ahead. So here question may be asked, suppose in Sanskrit, daridraya kim deyam? Definitely the answer is daridraya dhanam deyam. Similarly, jadaya kim deyam? जड़ाय किम देयम, तो वी कैन से दैट जड़ाय ज्ञानम देयम, और ज्ञानम देयम जड़ाय, दिस इज ऑल्सो द करेक्ट. देयम ज्ञानम जड़ाय, संस्कृत इज अ फ्लेक्सिबल लैंग्वेज, यू कैन चेंज द सीक्वेंस ऑफ द वर्ड्स अकॉर्डिंग टू योर चॉइस. सिमिलरली पिपासिताय किम देयम, तो पिपासिताय पानीयम देयम. एंड लास्ट वन शुद्धिताय किम देयम, तो वी कैन से दैट शुद्धिताय भोजनम देयम. नाउ लेट्स वी प्रोसीड ऑन श्लोक नंबर सिक्स. श्लोक नंबर सिक्स इज दैट लोभात क्रोधः प्रभवति, लोभात कामः प्रजायते, लोभात मोहत्सनाशश्च लोभः पापस्य कारणम्. आई रिपीट अगेन, लोभात संधि इज दैट, लोभात क्रोधः प्रभवति, लोभात कामः प्रजायते, लोभात मोह च नाशश्च लोभः पापस्य कारणम्. लोभ पापस्य कारण, लोभ ए पापनु कारण छे. व्हाट एवर सीन generally we do. That one is because of lobha. Lobha means greed. So here we should remain away from greed. Don't be greedy. This one is the moral of this sloka. So let me see the translation. Lobhat krodha prabhavati. Prabhavati means is born. Give the birth, we call it. Is born. Krodha, anger. And lobha means greed. So anger is born from greed. Whenever you become greedy, so you want to achieve that particular things. And suppose you are unable to get it, to achieve it. So because of frustration, you become very angry. And whenever you are seized by or you are caught by anger, at that time you stop thinking. You are unable to utilize your mind in a proper way. And whenever you stop using your mind, so for that particular period, you become mad or you become foolish. And foolish people can do anything. So anger is the biggest enemy of a human beings. And generally, we become angry whenever the something does not happen according to our desire. Because at that particular time, we become greedy. So here, poet said that anger is born from greed. Next, he said that lobha kamah prajayate. Prajayate again means is born. And kamah, that is desire. Desire is born out of greed. Kama. Generally, desire first occurs due to thought in our mind. Thought which turn into desire. Desire which turn into intensive desire. And ultimately, whenever there is an intensive desire in your mind, it turns into action. And whenever you perform the particular action, so definitely, every action which turns into result. And suppose the result it is good, so you repeat that particular action again and again and again. Maybe, suppose, आपको दूसरे को मदद करने में मजा आती है. और जब वो सामने वाला व्यक्ति खुश होता है तो आप भी खुश होते हैं. तो आपको ये एक्शन टू हेल्प अदर्स विच इज रिजल्टेड इन टू हैप्पीनेस एंड देयर फॉर यू परफॉर्म दैट एक्शन अगेन एंड अगेन एंड अगेन. अल्टीमेटली सच एक्शन दिस लीड्स यू टूवर्ड्स योर कैरेक्टर. आपका चरित्र इसी में से निर्माण होता है. एंड सपोज you tease others and your friends become very angry, and seeing the angry mood of your friend, you enjoy it. जिसको हम राक्षसी प्रवृत्ति बोलते हैं, दूसरे को परेशान देखकर हम खुश होते हैं, तो that action is also repeated again and again and again. And ultimately, your characters also become so. You enjoy only when others are in the problem. So this is very bad nature. So we should think about this properly. Next he said that lobha cha moha cha. Two words are there. Lobha means temptation. And मोह नाशह च. मोह मीन्स टेम्पटेशन. एंड नाशह च destruction, nashah, destruction. So we can say that temptation and destruction are caused by greed. देखो greed से क्या क्या नुकसान होता है. You are too much attached with particular thing, and whenever you are unable to get it, definitely, slowly and gradually, it leads you toward the complete destruction. For example, in Ramayana, Ravan ko Sita ka lobh tha. He want to gain mother Sita, aur इसी वजह से उसने भगवान राम की जो पत्नी है उसका हरण करता है और भगवान राम को रावण के साथ युद्ध करना पड़ता है. उसी वक्त वो भगवान राम को पहचान नहीं पाता है क्योंकि उसको मोह है. मोह किसका? मोह सीता को प्राप्त करने का. और इसी वजह से बिकॉज ऑफ द टेम्पटेशन लॉर्ड राम किल रावण. तो रीजन ऑफ द रावण्स डिस्ट्रक्शन इज टेम्पटेशन बिकॉज ही वॉज ग्रीडी. सो हियर इट इज सेड दैट टेम्पटेशन एंड डिस्ट्रक्शन आर कॉज्ड बाय ग्रीड. एंड लास्ट वन इट इज सेड दैट लोभ पापस्य कारणम. Greed is the cause, कारण, cause. पापः, sin. Greed is the cause of sin. अब जितने भी पाप करते हैं उसका reason मुख्यतः greed है. सब पाप आपका लोभ की वजह से ही होता है. तो greed is the cause of sin. तो here the complete translation it is. Anger is born from greed. Desire is born from greed. Temptation and destructions are caused by greed. Greed is the cause of sin. And that's it in today's video. Remaining slok we see in the next video. Thank you very much for watching this video.